Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on a faulty crankshaft position sensor, along with some symptoms and diagnostics. The crankshaft position sensor is also often referred to as the CPS for short, or just the crank position sensor. And just as the name suggests, the crankshaft position sensor is responsible for monitoring the position and rotational speed of the crankshaft. And it is a very vital engine component. The car's computer, essentially, often referred to as the ECU, DME, or PCM, uses this signal from the crankshaft position sensor to control and manage multiple other engine parameters, such as fuel injection, ignition timing, and multiple other important engine parameters. So ultimately, the crankshaft position sensor is an incredibly important and critical part in proper engine operation. Without a working crankshaft position sensor, there's a pretty wide variety of symptoms that can appear. So that said, let's go ahead and jump in and talk about some of those symptoms that you may notice with a crankshaft position sensor failure. A check engine light, as well as fault codes stored in the computer, are going to be two of the most common symptoms associated with a faulty crankshaft position sensor. Outside of that, you can notice a plethora of other symptoms, including hard starts or long cranks. The engine might crank but not actually turn over. You might notice that the transmission is stuck in a certain gear while you're actually driving, if the car is even able to run and run properly. You might also notice reduced power, the engine stalling, or stuttering, hesitation, tons of different things again here. This isn't even a totally exhaustive list, just a few of the more common symptoms associated with crankshaft position sensor failure. And again, just to reiterate, this is a critical component, and that's why these symptoms can vary so widely. This is responsible for sending a very important signal to the ECU that's then used to help the engine determine how much fuel to inject, when to inject the fuel, when to ignite the spark plugs and the air-fuel mixture. Lots of important things that the crankshaft position sensor aids the computer in determining. One example of how wildly symptoms can vary. Personally, I actually ran into two different crankshaft position sensor failures on two of my BMWs within the last year or so. On the newer vehicle, it's a 2007 BMW 335i. When my crankshaft position sensor failed on that engine, it ran into very long cranks. It would take about 7 to 10 seconds cranking, and the engine would ultimately turn over, and it would allow me to go in reverse, and when I put the vehicle in drive, it would be essentially just stuck in third gear. It wouldn't shift out of third gear. The car drove fine. Everything was good. It was just, again, stuck in third gear. But I didn't have any issues with rough idle or misfires or really any other issues at all, apart from the check engine light and a fault code stored in the computer indicating that there was an issue with the crankshaft position sensor. The reason for the long crank was likely due to the fact that the engine couldn't pick up on the crankshaft position early on. But ultimately, as it cranked, it was able to use other engine parameters to at least get the engine started, and then it was able to understand or know where the crankshaft position and rotational speed was using other signals and other sensors within the engine. On the other hand, the other car I ran into that issue was a 1989 BMW 325i. On that vehicle, obviously a lot older, doesn't have the more advanced computers, software, and sensors and electrical components of some of the newer engines. So on that one, when the crankshaft sensor failed, I actually didn't get any symptoms at all. It was just one day the engine suddenly wouldn't turn over. It would crank and crank and crank, and the engine just wouldn't turn over. There was really no other indication and nothing to go off of, since again the engine wouldn't start, so I couldn't really tell what was wrong apart from the fact that it wouldn't start. And so ultimately I was able to back into the fact that it was a crankshaft position sensor failure on that. Ultimately just goes to show how widely the symptoms can vary, from having one car that wasn't able to start at all to another car that was able to start and run relatively fine. It was just stuck in third gear and refused to shift into any lower or higher gears than that. So lots of different symptoms, really just depending on how the sensor fails and what year, model, engine you have in your vehicle. Moving on to some diagnostics for a crankshaft position sensor failure, the number one best thing is just going to have an OBD2 scanner on hand. Plug that into the vehicle's OBD2 port and scan for the codes. If you get any crankshaft position sensor codes, diodes, which would be P0335, P0336, P0337, and P0338 being some of the most common ones. That's usually a dead giveaway that you are having issues with your crankshaft position sensor. Ultimately, any modern engine with an OBD2 port and a more advanced ECU or computer should easily pick up on these problems. The crankshaft position sensor is a sensor, it's electrical, and so at that point, the ECU will very easily be able to pick up on the fact that it's not getting the expected data, it's not getting any data at all, and that will immediately and automatically trigger the check engine light as well as one of these fault codes indicating a potential crankshaft position sensor issue. So again, that OBD2 scanner is really going to be your best bet for tracking down and getting started in the process of diagnosing a faulty CPS. Now, if you do run into any of those codes and some of these symptoms, it is almost always the crankshaft position sensor, but there are a couple other issues that could be the cause of the fault codes and symptoms that you're experiencing. So a couple other things, the wiring or the circuit to the crankshaft position sensor could be problematic, and very rarely, but occasionally, the actual ECU or the car's computer itself might be having issues. So if you do want to do some additional diagnostics to specifically confirm what the issue is, you can use an oscilloscope to essentially check the waveform from the crankshaft position sensor and see if anything is looking off, if it's inconsistent or non-existent or just varying a lot. And then from there, you can use a multimeter to actually check the voltage to all the wiring, the circuits, all of that, and eliminate any wiring or circuit issues as being the cause, which would ultimately lead you to the crankshaft position sensor. But again, it almost always is the crankshaft position sensor. And fortunately, on most vehicles, it's a relatively inexpensive part. It's about a $20 to $50 sensor. Of course, can vary depending on your specific year, make, model, etc. But generally about a $20 to $50 sensor. And on most engines, it's relatively easy and straightforward to access and replace the sensor. I know on the two cars, when I replaced some on mine, the older BMW, it took me all of about 10 or 15 minutes to replace that crankshaft position sensor. And on the newer 2007 BMW, that one took me about an hour and a half. It was been a slightly tough to access area. And it's generally a pretty simple and inexpensive fix, even for less experienced DIYers or mechanics. So I usually just recommend going ahead and replacing that crankshaft position sensor, unless you have the rest of these tools and testing methods easily on hand. Otherwise, you might end up spending more money on all of the tools and equipment than you even would on a crankshaft position sensor. That's part of the reason why it is generally just best to go ahead and replace that sensor if you are getting the fault codes indicating there is an issue there. In summary of everything here, the crankshaft position sensor is a critical component in engine operation. The ECU relies on the signal from the crankshaft position sensor to determine a lot of other engine parameters like fuel injection, ignition timing, and numerous other things. And so ultimately, that's why a crankshaft position sensor failure can cause such a wide array of potential symptoms and drivability issues, ranging from the engine not starting at all to severe issues like the engine stalling or just running very rough with a rough idle, stuttering, hesitation, or even the transmission getting stuck in a certain gear so that it can monitor the position of the crankshaft and keep the engine running relatively smoothly. And then when it comes to diagnostics, just using an OBD2 scanner to scan for any fault codes, confirming that you do have a crankshaft position sensor code stored in the ECU via the OBD2 scanner. And from there, your next best bet, oftentimes, especially if that sensor is easy to access and replace and fairly cheap, just going ahead and replacing that, knocking it out, is often the best bet. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more. Thanks, everyone.